Hi, welcome back. Today we are going to review another Caveco Sport pen, and because it is inside this paper cardboard box, this cardboard box, you know it is a plastic Caveco Sport. So the pen I'm going to show you today is this Caveco Skyline Sport White. Simple. This pen was sent to us for review by Caveco, and I'll show you what is this pen. So, this pen is similar to every other Caveco Sport. It is a plastic one. It is the Skyline series, which means that this imprint on the cap that says Caveco Sport, also the medallion on the top of the cap and the nib, they are all silver colored. So, this is the Skyline line. The pen is like every other Caveco Sport. This one is not easy to see because it's quite hard to light up this scene with such a white pen. So, it has the Caveco logo on top of the cap. The cap has 8 facets and the barrel is cylindrical. It has this knurled part on the end. It says made in Germany on the bottom, and when you unscrew, you have very slightly hour-shaped section, quite small, and a nib that has the Caveco logo there, and it is an F nib, as you can see, with the regular Caveco feed that has the Caveco logo in the opposite direction of the nib. And this is it. Inside the pen, it takes cartridges or the small Caveco converters, and this is it. If you want, you can check any other review that I made about Caveco Sports, and this pen is quite similar. The things that are important in this pen: this is a very small pocket pen. It is made of ABS plastic. This one is white. You have them in lots of colors. Some are regular editions, some are special editions. The pen is very short and it's not easy to write with when it is unposted. Although I can use it, but I don't have giant hands. If you have giant hands, you can post the pen. It posts quite securely and deeply, but you get a full-sized pen. Just to show you, and I already did this with other Caveco pens, if I compare it with a Parker Centennial Lufold and with a Lamy Safari, you can see the Caveco is just a little bit, let me put some shadow here, is just a little bit longer than the other two. Okay, you may say this is cheating because the Caveco is posted, the other two are not. But I don't think it's really comfortable to write with a Parker Centennial Lufold posted. It gets too giant and it doesn't post that securely. And also the Lamy Safari. When it's posted, I think it's too long. At least I don't post it, and I'm just showing you that this pen was meant to be posted. These ones were not, but you can do whatever you want, of course. So, this is a short pen. It's not a very wide one, but it is quite comfortable to write with if you post it. Some people say it's not the best pen for long writing sessions. I can understand that because it's short and it's not the most weighted pen. I think the AEL Sports, which means they are made of aluminum and not plastic, ABS plastic, are more comfortable to use because they have some extra weight. But these are perfectly balanced, perfectly good to write pens, and they are an easy EDC and they cost around 20 euros. So I think this is a very nice low budget pen that you can carry everywhere, and you have lots of nibs to choose from. The nibs on this pen are not easily interchangeable. You have to slip the nib and feed out. The nibs on the AL Sport, the Look Sport, the Art Sport, AC Sport, they all have threads, and you can unscrew the whole unit of nib and feed. In these ones, you can't. You have to pull it out, but it will work if you want to exchange nibs. Another thing people like to do with these pens is to eyedropper them. I think they are not the most perfect pens to be eyedroppered because you can't, in these pens, because they are the nib and feed, they are not threaded, you can take it out to apply some silicone grease. But on the nib and feed, and sometimes they may leak. But lots of people like to use them eyedroppered because I think they are pocket pens, EDC pens. I don't see the point to eyedropper a pocket pen because if you have an accident with this, you will get big mess inside your pocket. I don't think it makes that sense. I like to use it with the cartridge, but once again, you can do it. Can do it, and you can do whatever you want with your own pen. Said this all, let's go for the writing sample. And here we are with our paper. Let's write with this pen to show you how it performs. So, this is the Caveco Skyline Sport in white. This one has the fine steel nib. The paper is the usual Rhodia dot pad, and the ink is the Caveco Royal Blue. As you can see, this nib has a very nice flow and it writes. Let me try just focus this. Oh, good. Well, if this has a very good flow and this pen won't skip unless you don't hold the pen in the right position. It writes really well. And if you see, you can have. It is wet enough to write, and maybe it is a little too thick for a fine nib, but it's okay with many European F nibs. About line variation, in Caveco Sport you can almost always get some. You have to press the nib a little. It is not meant to do it, but as you can see, you can really have some line variation. It's not that the pen flex, but if you really press it hard, it will do it. Just be careful not to ruin the nib. When you try to write upside down, usually you can do it also. And it writes as an extra fine. I found that some Caveco nibs run dry after doing this for a while, and others keep on writing for some more time. This one stopped writing, but now it's writing again. When you're writing the right position, there is no problem with it. So, it really has a great flow. The nib is very smooth. I see and I read lots of criticism about Caveco nibs. I didn't find any really bad Caveco nib. I think some of the problems are with B nibs. I don't like to use broad or extra broad or double broad nibs, so maybe I didn't never find a baby bottoms problem, but probably that's what happened to some of you users. I never had this problem and I really like the Caveco nibs. And This is it. I have to say also that I'm not saying that I didn't have any problems with Caveco Nib because Caveco sent me these pens for review. I have to say that I was a collector of Caveco pens and a huge fan of these pens because of the way they write much before I started blogging and before I started having Caveco pens for free to test. So, this is it for today. I have to thank Caveco for sending the pen for review and to thank you all for watching these videos. If you liked it, please don't forget to subscribe. See you next time. Bye.